story of Purim was a long time ago.
The story of Purim features a young girl named Esther.
Purim is a celebration that we remember how Esther saved her people and herself because of how evil Haman was.
So first of all, the king has a party.
But this one party lasted 7 days or more.
And then he called in his servant to go get Queen Vashti
to come over and show off her most beautifulest beauty.
But she refuses. He banishes her.
Banished from the castle.
He decided
to get all the most beautifulest girls.
Esther hears of the news and tells her Uncle Mordecai.
Mordecai, Mordecai, Uncle Mordecai. Could I please go to the castle? There's a big, big party.
He says, you may go. Just don't reveal our family secret that we are Jews. Then finally, the day of the beauty competition arrives.
And when she first got there, standing up on that stage, the king immediately looked at that woman with she was beautiful, like more beautiful than Queen Vashti. He was like, that's the one. That's the one. I will not choose tomorrow. That's the one.
And Esther was chosen as the queen.
A few days later, he picks Haman as his prime minister.
He was supposed to be like the person that was in charge.
Haman walks out and demands everybody bows to him.
But Mordecai, he refused.
It would be disobeying my God's law. But Haman was mad.
He was so mad.
Haman was plotting with the king to kill all the Jews. He said, may I kill all the Jews in the city?
Every baby, every child, every person. So on the 13th day, they were going to get killed. So he got a ring put on his finger. That's very odd for a man to put a ring on another man. He's not like marrying a man. Even though he's a man.
And Haman went home and was very happy. But he went home and told his wife about Mordecai.
She said, why don't you build a gallows in the backyard?
Mordecai is worried about Esther. Later that night, he goes to Esther's windowsill.
Esther, 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 please.
You must go to the king. She says, the king has not asked for me for months, days, weeks. And then Mordecai said, this is God's plan, Esther. He wants to use you in a supernatural way.
If I perish, I perish.
Esther went to the king
and he tells her she may come in and that she will not die. She asked for him and Haman to come to dinner.
And then she did that again the second night and then the third night. On that third night, she told the king what he really wanted.
Haman is plotting to kill me and my people. I am a Jew. The king gets in such a rage that he storms out of the room.
He stormed out of the room and then he came back in with soldiers. And then they said, there is a gallows in Haman's backyard, standing 50 feet tall.
And so the king said, hang Haman on it.
Haman was in such pain.
His way for being hung was, Esther and Mordecai went to the king, and the king chose Mordecai as his prime minister.
The king said this time, everybody bow down to this great, wonderful man who saved my life. The people were happy.
And they lived happily ever after.
That's the end. Bye-bye.